Unicorn drives. You know.
There's that. Lucy's little spot. Anyway, it's sweet. As usual, I've been trying to just stay busy, mostly breaking shit more than I'm fixing shit, but I just, anyway, today I was just tinkering, trying to put a face on Rembrandt, and that license plate seemed to just look the best. Anyway, if you ask me, I'd swear to God, at least the car is smiling. Anyway, that's all I'm gonna know about that. Well, after a long Sunday, we were semi-productive. We've got the back of this car pretty much, I'm gonna say, framed. Anyway, yeah, there's gonna be a metal skeleton on it, and the top is definitely, it's got a little shape down at the bottom. I don't know how it's gonna work out, but anyway, I got a guy that's smarter than the board helping me, so hopefully. Yeah, I mean, it's something to anchor wood to, I suppose, and the wood will be straight, so then it'll come out nice-ish. I don't know what's going on. I don't know. It's a boat tail. But it's got curves, man. It has got some good, like we used to say, it's got some good bones. It really does. It's got some good bones. Grandpa looks a little tore up. But look at that. Oh, that's a good view of it right there. Anyway. Yep. Pretty crazy. I don't understand. It is. Yeah, that's why we're gonna put wood, and the wood is going to be straight. And we're gonna anchor the wood to the kind. Two-inch wide strip is going to follow this whole top somehow. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This has been a day of chaos and mayhem, boys and girls. We got Bugattis laying everywhere. Those are our inspiration cars. Yep. See the hood? Yeah. We're gonna do some hood modifications. My idea that I would like to do is actually make the cowl add a piece to the front square. There. Ba-boom, ba-boom. And then move the radiator right up to the front. I mean, it does go back behind the fenders, but I'd rather have the radiator even with the fenders and a longer hood. So anyway, that's what I'm gonna do there. Should be fucking amazing. Anyway, I'm so excited about this project.
Let's see what your daddy's doing. Hi, Bill.
Oh my God.
What are you doing?
Doggy pouch.
We brought you some water.
Oh, thank you.
What are you doing?
I'm taking over where the guy with that welding rig left off. And those are his welds with gas, that tank there. And there's my weld without gas. He made that hoop, and I made this hoop. I mean, this is going to get covered up with other metal, so you know, I can grind my weld smooth and I can continue on with the project. So it makes me very happy. I'm not sitting here just wanting to grind and weld.
Good.
So yeah, what I'm going to do first today is just basically start with the end of the seat backs. So that way I can have a frame structure right here, which the hinge will attach to, which I can build the framework for the trunk onto. So basically I have to have an end right here and a back, and then the hinges will go right here, and then that piece I will make the structure for the back, hopefully. And yeah, the doors are done. He's just got to put them together. So that was really nice. So I'm just going to say that, you know, it's all up to me and how well I can cut and attach sheet metal to the shape.
Oh,
but I'm just going to say, I like my side just as good. If you look at the film, the two sides, they look pretty symmetrical. And
this
is my little waterfall that comes down between the seats.
Okay.
It's happening. I don't know whose truck that is.
I hope it's my Bugatti oil bottles.
Oh, this is the rusty can. I'll be fine though, right?
I washed it with a bottle washer.
Did you look in there? Well, Unicorn Drives. It was a successful hardcore day of cutting and grinding. I got a lot of tuning to do. You know, I was welding with no freaking tip on my shit. Just, oh, look at that. I fucked it up a little bit. Well, anyway, I finally gave in. It was dark. Yeah, it's a big mess. But normally I clean it all up, but anyway, I'm not. I ran to the store and got some reinforcement supplies. A new tip and a tip, and that's the tip. And I have another stinger, because I have another one of those. If that part comes off, maybe I could just swap that out, but who cares about all that bullshit? My exhaust fell off on the way to work the other day, so I was gonna fix that, but I'm too tired and really, I'm just trying to have an easy day. I mowed the lawn. That was my productive contribution before I go to work. All right, so anyway, off to the gallery. Oh, art supplies. That's right. I need some damn art supplies. Yeah, for my painting. Okay, see you when I get there.
Hi.
Hey.
What's going on?
So, long ways come in the last hour. I got my structure back here. This, well, I put one tack in, but this is my hinge structure. This bar going across will be the trunk, the beginning of the trunk frame, actually, that should drop in all nice and flush here. Here's my waterfall, all that's ready to be sheeted and bondoed and made to look all symmetrical.
But nice
anyway, these are my bird shit welds. I will grind them down because, you know me, I gotta grind them down so they look good. But I thought this was a pretty clever. I just broke my weld, but anyway, it was a shitty tack. Peace out, bro. It's coming along. Bootsy. Well, Unicorn Drives, it's been a long day of welding. I'm just gonna tell you, this is the most fabrication that I ever did over and over for the last weeks while I was suffering with a guy coming over like here and there. And I just said shitty welds are better than not getting it done, and you're not going to see them. So I got my booger weld action going. You want to see my booger welds? I didn't grind them yet. They're all rough, but this is the under the framework, and I plan to grind it and make it pretty and maybe fill in any spots. But dude, look at this shit. I have a trunk. Are you feeling me? I have a full on trunk. Yeah. Look, I have a trunk. I love it. I have a trunk. My trunk goes all the way up. These are MG hinges, of course. I didn't feel the need to put one in the middle. My trunk's pretty
pretty light. What do you think? My first ever fab job. It looks just like, you know, I gotta tune up some bars and stuff, but I figure I put the sheet, you know, do a little tune up, clean up, straighten up. I got all kinds of tricky ways to bend shit, but anyway, I'm excited to get some metal on, and I just wanted to get this framing part of the way. Oh, and I did my little waterfall treatment. Look at my little waterfall. So I'll probably make this panel that fills in all over here. I'll probably, I don't know, leave a little to bend over the edge there. I'm not sure how that works out, but I really like this waterfall detail. Yes, Jimmy-like. Yeah, this is the shit. Finally, I've been wanting to do fab work like this for so many years, and I'm fucking really made something out of metal. Anyway, I'm gonna drink some cocktails now. I'm tired. Later. Unicorn Drives, good morning. Back on the Bugatti aftermath of yesterday's chopping and grinding of the car and my arm. You know, anyway, buddy's shaking it off. So the lighting plays a really big trick on the side. It really looks like that side just freaking drops and that whatever, but you know, it's borderline on how much you can fill and not fill. And it's going to be like shaping a surfboard, I guess. I'm going to get my friend Steve Turnbull to help me, I think, because he's a sculptor and he's got a good eye, I think, and I bet he could help make it straight. So anyway, yeah, that's the plan. And then I think we're going to have some kind of a center thing there. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. All I know is I'm too far along to not just finish this cone and then try to see what I can do to it. Shit. I don't even know how I'm going to deal with the bottom of it, actually, once I get it around the side. I'm just contemplating. Yeah, I don't know. I gotta put a piece of metal on the bottom of this, I think. Yeah, I guess I could just have it shut like that. Yeah, I guess that's what I'm gonna do. It's gonna shut like that. Anyway, this is pretty homebrewed. And anyway, I posted a post the other day on a old car dude thing, and more comments than I've ever seen ever from the back of this. And anyway, it's almost a challenge now to see if we can make this look good, because the pain on my body to grind and shape and redo that versus just finish it and go to Bondo and sandpaper, and I'm, you know, I like a challenge. I'm gonna try to make a big old round, nicely shaped butt on this car somehow. Anyway, wish me luck. Thanks for all the comment and feedback, and you know, buddy would like it very much if you would, buddy, tell them you would like it if they would like, comment, and subscribe. Right, buddy? Buddy. Hey. He doesn't listen to me. Don't ask me why. Oh. Unicorn Drives. We're shredded. We did a lot of shredding of metal today. Shredded my arm a little bit. Yeah, you know, some butterfly stitches back at it. Anyway, don't judge me. There's no Bondo yet, and there's going to need to be a lot. But anyway, my car has a badonkadonk. Look at the badonkadonk on that. It's like, I don't know. I was gonna bring it down, and then I left it. Oh, but you know, I like the round. I like my round. Well, it could have sloped down and been round, but I just it gave it a little more of a sexy butt. I'm just gonna say, yeah. Of course, I went for the skin instead of the inner structure there. Why does that look off? It does. Oh no, it looks good. Whew. Car body. I realize that people that cut things very precisely and are meticulous, they take five times longer, but it looks five times better until you put Bondo on. So that's why I'm fucking going with getting her done. Because, you know, shaping Bondo will be no problem. And anywhere I see anything poking out, I can just hit it with a hammer and it's going to move enough. But yeah, it's nice to see a back on a car. Yes, there it is. Oh, now it doesn't go. Oh, before it went all the way to the thing without the seats in it. So with the seats in it, it only goes that far. Unbelievable. I really like the inside, actually. Oops. Oops. I'm going to have some fun with Bondo. Don't know why I made that come in like that. How's it going to look when I make the little tray like that? Gonna sit right the fuck in it is what it's gonna do. It's a lot of work. It really is a lot of work. Bat tail soon. Steve, I'm going to need a little bit of sculpting help after I get it roughed in. I'm sure you have an eye for symmetry anyway. Yeah, I'll help you with the lift. You help me get this thing symmetrical. Shape it. I don't know. I think, you know, I don't think it's going to be too far off, but it definitely could use a sculptor eye. Well, if I was doing drywall, I'd be saying, well, that's my first wipe of mud. I don't know. I'm no Da Vinci, but I feel like, you know, I already can see I need to put a little there. And I like that. That's the highest, so I got to add to there. Because I can't take anything down from here, so I'm working with whatever humps I got or the humps I get. But I like it. Just make it symmetrical. I don't know. I can see what I gotta do. I need a little more there. And obviously there's nothing there yet. My main focus actually was trying to see of the high spots and get shit filled up to that, basically up here. And anyway, yeah, it's gonna take some shaping, but I'm gonna work on it.